Hi, I'm Doug Binks. In this video, I'll show you recent changes to Avoyd's rendering. I've added shadows, ambient occlusion, distant material sampling, and a procedural texture for the gameplay element we call culture. Culture shows here as a glowing blue texture with a moving wave pattern. In game, cultures change the properties of materials and are associated with teams. For example, players can more easily change materials that belong to their own culture. Here's how the game looks without these changes. And here's a side-by-side comparison. I put the new rendering code on the right-hand side. The lack of colors in the distance was previously required because the low detail generation wasn't sampling materials. I now point sample these and also broadcast the information over the network to clients so this works when playing online. Now I'll change the shader to output only the ambient occlusion. This has two components. One is per vertex, and the other is from a volume texture sampled in the fragment shader. The vertex ambient occlusion is derived from immediate voxel neighbor occupancy, and so it adds a high-frequency ambient occlusion component. The volumetric ambient occlusion uses short ray casts in the voxel octree, and here I'm using a resolution 4 times lower than the level of detail resolution for vertex generation. Adding in the lighting term in the shader, and we can see the shadowing. This is a component of the volumetric texture used by the ambient occlusion, and it currently has the same resolution. Once again, I'm using raycasts, but here, just one raycast towards the principal light. Finally, I add the procedural texture for the culture. This test level only has one culture, but game levels will have several, visible as regions with different colors and patterns. There are 3 different patterns involved. A large moving wave pattern, which multiplies a stationary random per voxel amplitude. Detailing here is simply alternating sets of cubes and spheres, visible as circles and squares where the surface intersects them. Since the texturing is done as a procedural 3D calculation, no texturing projection problems arise. I spent most of my effort on optimizing the code to keep the rapid updating working. This is needed for the strategic action gameplay we'll be focusing on in Avoyd. The per vertex ambient occlusion and volume light textures I calculate on the CPU, with updates done asynchronously using a task system. Currently, I'm regenerating lighting and ambient occlusion iteratively for the entire world, so there's a short delay for distant shadows to appear when editing. In future, I hope to support directional occlusion, though I may move to light propagation volumes, again using the voxel octree on the CPU so this lighting can include off-screen geometry and light sources, unlike most current GPU techniques. Because the work is done asynchronously on the CPU, lower-end hardware still performs well, with some lag in building and level of detail updates, but good frame times, so there's no movement or mouse lag. If you have any questions, you can reach me on Twitter, at Doug Binks, or email me at doug@enkisoftware.com. For the latest news, you can follow Avoyd Game on Twitter and Facebook, and remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you want to learn more about Avoyd and its history, head over to our website, avoyd.com. You'll find a FAQ and the development log where I talk in more detail about the techniques I use to make the game.